Also in the heat index this morning, it's going to be a summer of love for one San Francisco woman. She has vowed to go on 100 dates in the next couple of months. She's going to be busy. She's calling her project 100 Dates of Summer, and her reasons for doing it might surprise you. Abby Boudreau has her story.
100 Dates of Summer. Sounds like a movie title, doesn't it? But for Elise Moreno, it's better than any old rom-com. It's her real life.
The goal of this is not to find a boyfriend. It really is just exploring myself and getting to know other people.
Elise, a self-admitted serial monogamist who for the first time in 6 years is single and loving it.
I realize that it's an extreme, but it's just fun.
She's blogging about her dates on Tumblr, even posting photos and video.
Woo! I have a 2-drink maximum rule, which is pretty important for my safety. I can go on second dates, but they don't count towards the total.
From coffee dates and concerts to putt-putt golf, the 25-year-old San Francisco native started her dating experiment 2 months ago, and already she's been on 32 dates, meeting her matches on OkCupid.com.
I really have only had maybe 3 not so great ones. All of my dates know about the project. I'm not trying to trick anybody. I'm not trying to pull one over. I'm not even trying to get free dinners.
Relationship expert Paul Carrick Brunson says 100 dates is bound to lead to some rejection.
If you're going to go on 100 dates, you have to realize it's going to be an emotional roller coaster, because 100 dates could mean 99, 98, 97 rejections.
And drawing from her dozens of dates, Elise shares a little advice with other fellow daters.
I think that the energy that you put out into a date is what's going to be bounced back to you.
And while she's hopeful she'll make it to date 100, she says it's less about the number and more about finding her own voice again.
I'm just going one day, one date at a time.
For Good Morning America, Abby Boudreau, ABC News, Los Angeles.